Programm.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, and to shed more light on the current economic progress that Egypt is achieving, we're joined over the phone by Dr. Hanadi Ragai, human resources expert. Good afternoon, Dr. Hanadi.
Good afternoon, dear. How are you?
How are you, sir? Dr. Hanadi, Egypt placed third in Forbes Middle East list of largest economies in the Arab region, with a total of gross domestic product value that is expected to jump to $394.3 billion in 2021. How do you read this?
Okay, I think this happens regarding to Mr. President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, for the stability progress, which would be in 2030. And there is a lot of objectives during this project. That's why the economy has jumped that much, as you mentioned now, because he opens a lot of investment in Egypt, either during the businessmen in Egypt or outside of Egypt. And
yes,
also he gave a big chance for the females to start working. And that's why this, his vision is totally help Egypt to jump this to this situation.
Well, President Sisi is keen on the economic file. He adopted many procedures to boost it. How do you evaluate the measures taken to return the economy of Egypt on track?
Okay, all the missions that Egypt take it to return the economy, actually it was, I think that comes from the proper studying for the cases, and they put a plan for each step that they have to work with it, budgeting. That's why I think we success during this sustainability vision and mission for the, Egypt.
What's the world reaction towards the mega projects being implemented here in Egypt, across the country? And in your point of view, how did the development we're witnessing nowadays in Egypt help in changing the world's vision towards Egypt?
The mega projects help the vision totally, because Mr. President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, first of all, he helped with the digital transformation. He helped the IAS, holding a lot of conferences, talk to them. And that's, you can find nowadays, most of the, let's say, the new generation from 20s to 30s ages, they are always continuing thinking to have their own business. Central Bank of Egypt is helping with a lot of loans for SMEs, and this totally helps our economy to jump and give chance for all the people in a different level, in a different segment in our society, to think for their own project. And we can say also, during the COVID-19 pandemic, a lot of females or males who lost their job, they start to work their project via the online project. That's why.
Do you believe that these national mega projects could turn Egypt from a developing country to a developed one?
I couldn't hear you. Would you please repeat the question again?
Could these mega projects, in your opinion, turn Egypt from a developing country to a developed one?
Yes, absolutely. Because if you can find now, as I mentioned, this mega project, it helps all the segments, and it's targeting all the segments. Even if you don't have a big budget to start your project, you can do it, whatever. You can have a loan. As I mentioned also, the central bank is helping the people, helping all the Egyptian people to have their project. Okay, if we are talking about the SMEs or the people, their financial situations is in the medium level, what about our big businessmen? So that's why I think all the sectors supposed to support Egypt and budget with a lot of, you know, it has to be push with a lot of financials helping to the people, and this will let Egypt to move from the stage to another stage. And
yes,
I think Egypt already turned to different era regarding this project.
Yes. Right. How do you view the latest development projects that are taking place in the governorates also?
Yes, it was. I think it's a great idea because the government also, first of all, we talk about the Egyptian pool. It has a totally digital and leadership transformation. We can talk about a lot of, governmental sector investment. All the businessmen now, all the procedures, it becomes very easy. We are helped the investors to invest in Egypt. That's why I think the governmental sector is also their leadership transformation and the mindset things totally changed. The health ministry, a lot of ministries. We can also mention the education ministry. Even the kids now, they are using the tablets, as you see in the exam, and maybe the KGs also, they are using this way. So I think we are matching with this development vision for the President Abdel Fattah.
Yes. Also the housing projects witnessed a leap under President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi. Tell us more about the latest mega housing projects.
Okay. In New Cairo, Mr. Abdel Fattah al-Sisi is making, the new train to link all the Egypt and Giza together. Okay. Mm-hmm. If we are looking for a lot of succession stories and success stories, for in many countries, once you solve the problem for the transportation and make it easier for the people, that means you are linking east to west, north to south, okay? So when we are moving to the difference in the new Cairo, as Mr. Abdel Fattah al-Sisi makes, the real estate giving a lot of facilities for even the Egyptian people and the Egyptian investors, that helps. You can put installments, all the segments they can, pay a lot in the real estate project. And also we can see this in Al Alamein in Alexandria. Okay, that means also it's another vision. You can find now the other roads and the transportation. It's much, much easier for the people. That's why.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Do you agree that all ministries and agencies are witnessing a renaissance?
Again, please, I couldn't hear.
Do you agree that all ministries and agencies are witnessing a renaissance during the current time?
Yes, absolutely. What we have it now, we can call it in the management as a business acumen. What happens? All these ministries, they are helping each other as a stakeholder. And each ministry is supporting the others. For example, if we can talk about the education ministry, investment, Egyptian post, all of them, Central Bank of Egypt, we are all helping each other. That's why the step is very big and fast. Yes.
The 2030 Sustainable Development Strategy is directed to end hunger, achieve food security, and improve nutrition and promote sustainable agriculture. How far were these goals implemented during the last 5 years?
It was very obvious to all the world regarding, first of all, the media was working much, much great these days by helping the hunger people or the poor people in Egypt. Mm-hmm. Also, Mr. Abdel Fattah al-Sisi held maybe next week meet the conference for Haya Karima.
Yes.
It was a great idea, which makes all the people in Egypt now, we're going to have a poor people, but at least they have the limit to live. The minimum of salaries, it is starting, will be increasing in 2022. This is a great vision to at least, even if we are having some poor people, but it's acceptable. You know what I mean? It's acceptable to be, just a medium or poor or the rich people. So that's why the hunger curve will be decreased because of the, the new project and the new vision for 2030 sustainability vision.
Okay, right. Well, I would like to thank you very much, Dr. Hanedi Ragoi, human resources expert. Many thanks for your insight. And dear viewers, with this, we come to the end of this edition of Cairo Local Time. Many thanks for watching and stay tuned for the top stories that will be coming up in a moment.